Hey, this is René and I'm back with another video. It's been a while since I released the last one, but yeah, I want to keep posting more videos from now on, but at least I will do a new MT5 programming tutorial, which will start today. And I will break the video or the whole series into different parts. So we have smaller videos of like 10 minutes, which will deal with a specific topic. And in the end, we will have a fully working expert advisor, which you can use to trade in the MetaTrader 5. Yeah, you requested more tutorials about MT5 or MQL5 programming. So here we go. To start off, I want to show you like the agenda. I wrote down 7 different points, bullet points. You can read them here, and I want to teach you how you can create a new expert advisor in the MetaTrader 5. I will teach you about variables, functions, and control structures. These are pretty much programming essentials, which you will need for any programming language. So this is not really limited to MQL5. You will also see this in C, C++, Java, Python, or any other programming language. And afterwards, we will go to, we will move on to more MetaTrader specific topics like reading indicator data, or like retrieving data from an indicator. In this case, we will use the RSI indicator to generate trading signals. And afterwards, we will use these exact signals to open trades. So I can show you the RSI on a chart. What we have here is the, what we have here is the Euro US dollar chart, but you can attach the RSI to any other chart and the expert advisor, of course. So the RSI should be here. Okay, there it is. So maybe you know the RSI indicator. It is the relative strength indicator, and it shows whether the market is pushing upwards or downwards, and it shows like how far it has already gone. And the logic or the thought of this indicator is that whenever this indicator value is above 70 or any other threshold that you define, then we put a short order, and if it's below 30, we will go long. So yeah, we will like try to use this indicator to build a simple strategy where we sell at 70 and buy at 30, and we will close like opposite positions at the exact other bound. So yeah, let's stop talking and let's start programming. First of all, you have to open the Meta Editor. Mine was already open, but I can close it, of course, to show you how you can open yours. In the upper left corner of the MetaTrader 5, you will find this little sign. It says MetaQuotes Language Editor, and you can click either on this, or you can go to Tools and click on MetaQuotes Language Editor here. If you do this, the MetaQuotes Language Editor or Meta Editor will pop off, and you can build expert advisor indicator and scripts in here. So first of all, you go to the upper left corner and you click on new to build a new expert advisor. You have 2 different options. You can use the expert advisor template, which is a plain expert advisor, so you can start from scratch, or you can use the expert advisor generator, where you can like type in easy conditions to build an expert advisor without real programming. But what I want to teach you is building an expert advisor from scratch, so you know how to program and how to modify or build your own expert advisor. So you simply click on next, and you type in a name for this expert advisor. I will simply call it RSI expert. Then you click on next again and finish. Okay, after you did this, you will have a expert advisor template, and what you see here is 3 essential functions. We will come to functions later. And you see some lines that are in gray. And all these gray lines can simply be removed because they are comments and they do not affect the functions of this program. So I delete all of them to make the code cleaner and easier to understand. We can also delete these three lines here because it's only the copyright link and version. If you compile this expert advisor, you can see what these stand for. I will find the RSI expert in my navigator in the MetaTrader now, and you can see that there is the RSI expert. I can attach it to a chart by simply double clicking the icon, and what we see here is the name of the expert. It's RSI expert. The version number is 1.00, and you see the copyright, and behind the copyright there is a link. So it's pretty much only some information that we can delete. So if I delete this and attach the RSI expert again, you will see that all this information are gone and we only see the name of the expert. But that's fine, we don't really need the information. You can keep it there, you can modify it if you want to. But yeah, first of all, I want to have a very clean expert advisor to show you the absolute basics. So what is left is three functions. It's the onInit, the onDInit, and the onTick function. These are functions that are defined or called by the MetaTrader itself. So whenever you use this program, these functions will be called by the system pretty much. So you don't have to take care of activating these functions. It will get done automatically. So I can show you when these functions are triggered by using a simple print statement. You can just write print and then open these parentheses and write something like on init in these quotation marks. So afterwards, you close the parentheses and write a semicolon. And if you compile this program, you do not get any errors. And now there will be a print statement in the experts tab of the MT5 if I activate this RSI expert. So what you see here is the print statement of onInit, because whenever the expert is initialized or attached to a chart, this onInit function will be executed. So it is also executed when I change the time frame, for example, because the expert advisor will be initialized again. So that's for the onInit. I can just copy this statement and put it in the onDInit. I write onDInit in here. And if I compile this, you can see that whenever I deinitialize the expert advisor or remove it from the chart, I get the onDInit output. So let me show you again. If I attach it to the chart, I get the onInit. If I change the time frame, the expert advisor will be deinitialized and initialized again in a matter of seconds. So you see this. First it gets deinitialized and then initialized again directly afterwards. And whenever I remove it from the chart, there will be also the onDInit function executed. Okay, so we have one function left, and this is the onTick function. It's you can say the most important function for many expert advisors, because it will get executed or will become executed with every single tick. If I attach the expert advisor again, you can see the onInit. And whenever there will be a tick, we will see that there is a print or a, so the onTick will be executed and we get this information in the experts tab. So, and that's the onTick function is the function you want to put all your programming logic in, because let me provide some comments. You can check conditions, you can open positions, you can close positions, you can modify positions, and you will do all this in the on tick for most of the time. So this is a really important function, and we will use this in the next videos. But first of all, I will end this video. We already reached 10 minutes, and what you learned in the last 10 minutes is that you can write, or you can build new expert advisors in the meta editor. You can create new expert advisors by clicking on new and creating new expert advisor, and then you will find all this information, like the comments in the beginning that are simply erased, that do not have any effect on the functionality, and you will find some properties like copyright, the link and the version, which you can also delete because they do not impact the functionality of the expert advisor. What we have left is three essential functions, which are system functions that are called by the MetaTrader itself, and they will be executed whenever the expert advisor is initialized or de-initialized, or whenever there is a tick in the market and the expert advisor is attached to the chart. So that's it for now. In the next tutorial, or the next part, we will have a closer look at variables. And I will see you then. Goodbye.